Monday night chat with Wong Chen.
Brought to you by the Member of Parliament for Kelana Jaya in collaboration with Invoke.
Assalamualaikum, salam sejahtera. Saya Dr. Munaziza Wan Ismail, Ahli Parlimen Perbatan Pau. Dan pada kali ini, sesi Parlimen kali ini yang terakhir dalam tahun ini, Rapugal ini, saya akan insyaAllah bawakan isu persepadanan semula daripada pihak PSPR nak buatkan persepadanan semula dalam negara kita, kawasan-kawasan parlimen, kawasan-kawasan DUN, dan saya akan menanya apakah asas mereka membuat persepadanan semula ini dan apakah mereka mengikut peruntukan dalam perlembagaan bawah 115, artikel 115, di mana mereka, pihak SPR, mesti ya, mesti mengikut nasihat dua orang yang kemahiran dalam satunya topografi, satunya mana penduduk-penduduk bermasalah di mana mereka berada, distribution of the population of Malaysia, and these two officers shall be appointed by the yeah, the king, yang di-Pertuan Agong. So jadi saya nak tanya, siapakah mereka berdua ini? Apakah nasihat yang mereka bagi kepada pihak SPR, memberikan alasan mereka membuat persepadanan semula ini? Inilah penting dalam jalan rangka bahawa kita nak buat persepadanan semula ini mestilah adil dan saksama dan memberikan representation atau bagaimana suara rakyat mesti dibawa dalam parlimen seadil mungkin. Itulah yang saya ingin sampaikan dan insyaAllah saya akan usahakan. Terima kasih.
Welcome back to Policy Monday. We're going to focus on a day in the life of the Member of Parliament of Kelana Jaya. We start off at 8:30. It's, we're in Parliament now. We're going to go for breakfast where I have a meeting with my staff and interns, and then we'll sort of like either chit-chat stuff over the weekend or things that we have to review. Now, I will generally have breakfast with my breakfast club, same YB same of Kota Melaka. Sometimes I'll be joined by Laksmana. A few early people that come to Parliament very early. We'll generally look at the order paper that is important. So that will tell you the order of the day. Yeah. And then the Parliament actually starts at 10 o'clock. We go in there and there'll be like Minister's question time followed by replies to our questions in Parliament. Okay. So orders will be sorted out by 11:30. Usually, if I have something to say to the press, I'll come out to the press area and then I'll give my press statement. And then we go back into Parliament and then we have a lunch break at 1 o'clock. Now, lunches is when we gather with my friends or occasionally we have meetings, a working lunch. So, for instance, this week we had our working lunch on Wednesday. That is basically all the members of Parliament of Keadilan will sit together and have our meeting. And then we go back to Parliament at 2:30, that's after the lunch break. And then from there, from 2:30 onwards, are usually to do with policy debates, whether parliamentarians are giving speeches, we're interjecting, we're supporting. And after a few hours of that, we usually go out for a short break, have tea or coffee. And that's when the real politicking really starts in Parliament, where we try to lobby other members of Parliament from the Pakatan Group and also from Barisan Nasional on certain issues that are important to us. So horse trading and stuff happens then. Then it goes back to Parliament session and then we go into more debates, and usually we will end Parliament around 5:30. That's the official time. But as you know, we have gone to Parliament up to 2 to 3 a.m. in the morning. At the moment in this week, we seem to be doing about 8:30 to 9:30 before Parliament rests. Yeah. So that's basically a day in the life of a Member of Parliament for Kelana Jaya.
Hello, apa khabar? Nama saya Tony Pua. Saya ahli parlimen bagi Petaling Jaya Utara. Bagi sesi parlimen kali ini, saya akan teruskan kerja saya untuk meminta supaya kerajaan bertanggungjawab terhadap wang-wang yang telah pun digunakan oleh 1MDB, yang hilang oleh 1MDB, yang telah pun diselewengkan oleh 1MDB dan syarikat-syarikat lain seperti Felda kepada pengurusan pihak pengurusan syarikat-syarikat dan juga pemimpin-pemimpin Barisan Nasional, termasuk Perdana Menteri Dato' Sri Najib Razak beliau kena jawab dan beliau masih belum jawab kenapa berbilion-bilion ringgit telah pun muncul dalam akaun peribadi bank beliau. So ini merupakan perkara yang penting bagi negara kita. Negara kita sekarang digelar sebagai negara kleptokrasi dan kita mesti bersatu mengatasi masalah ini. Terima kasih.
Nama saya Azman Ismail daripada Kuala Kedah, Parlimen Kuala Kedah P010, dan saya mewakili Parti Keadilan Rakyat di Parlimen. Kali ini saya untuk persidangan ini saya akan bercakap tentang isu-isu kesihatan dan juga isu pemakanan. Itu sebagai portfolio saya selama ini. Dan dalam titah ucapan Sri Paduka Baginda, beliau Baginda menyebutkan tentang masalah penyakit tidak berjangkit NCD. Itu memang bidang saya. Saya punya pandangan tersendiri berbeza dengan Kementerian Kesihatan, iaitu kebanyakan NCD ini bermula dengan paras insulin, itu saya akan tekankan. Dan tentang pemakanan, saya akan bercakap tentang isu kelapa sawit, terutamanya tentang pensijilan kelapa sawit Malaysia Mampan, MSPO, dan juga keperluan untuk kita memasarkan kelapa sawit dengan lebih agresif sebagai makanan sihat. Terima kasih.
Hello, I'm Dr. Jay Kumar. I'm from Sungai Siput, Parti Socialist Malaysia. For this session, I am particularly interested in a few issues. One of them is the state of our healthcare system. I'm very concerned that we are getting into a more neoliberal paradigm, which is affecting the patient care to our ordinary patients. The latest change the government has brought is this full-paying patient system, where government specialists are encouraged to do private practice in government hospitals. And I am very concerned that this will affect the quality of care to the non-paying patients. So I'm trying to speak on this in one of the Ucapan Penangguhan. The other issue I'm interested in this session would be the fate of contract workers. Now there are about 150,000 cleaners in government schools who are working under contractors. Previously they worked under the government, they were government servants. But now that whole service has been subcontracted out to private contractors, and many of them do not get paid their wages, they do not pay their EPF, you know, and I'm trying to look into that as well. The third issue is RUU355, if that ever comes up, because I think there's a need for rational discussion, you know, and not getting too emotional about it, and to see how we can find some way of dealing with an issue that shouldn't have been brought to Parliament in the first place, because we're not ready to discuss this, but it's been brought in here because of political reasons. We've got to see how to handle it without causing further disagreement between the communities. Thank you.
Hello, Assalamualaikum. My name is Dr. Mujahid Yusuf Rawa. I represent Parti Amanah Negara from the constituency of Parit Bunta in the North Perak. In this parliamentary session, I will focus on three things. One is about the sluggish economy and the problem that our country is facing. Number two, I will talk a little bit on the very foundation of this country, that is about unity and Islam as the religion of the federation. And the third issue that I shall focus on is about the TN50, on how the country should move forward, but it has to, in the first place, look backward for the last 50 years, what it has achieved. I hope in this parliamentary session, this debate will contribute to a healthy debate in the parliament. Thank you very much.
Hello, for Q&A this week, we have three basic questions. The first one is on GST. We asked the government whether they've done any socio-economic impact study for the rural area and the urban area since the implementation of GST 2 years ago. This is the most remarkable reply they gave. They said they did a study before they implement GST. So what is the purpose of doing a study before implementing when I ask whether they've done one after implementation of GST? But typical replies from Parliament is that very low quality, evasive, and at best trying to mislead you. Yeah. Now, second question is community matter. You know, we had a terrible, tragic fire in USJ2 last month. So I took this question and brought it to Parliament and asked whether the government, it's also related to GST by the way, asked the government whether they will waive or zero rate the GST for all firefighting equipment, basically smoke alarms and fire extinguishers. And no surprise, the reply came as no, they're not interested to give any waiver on this. And they argued that everybody can afford to buy this stuff, and that this stuff are small investments to make because the equipment can last 3 to 5 years. So there you have it, a completely out of touch government. The third question that I'm going to address is really on the Yemen war. Now, as you all know, the Yemen war is now into the third year. Third year. And Amanah is very, very gung-ho on this matter in particular. They are very interested because Amanah raised the issue that the United Nations published a report recently that Malaysia is involved in military actions in the Yemen war. Now, the minister, Hishamuddin, replied yesterday in parliament that they are not involved in any military action and that they are at the Saudi-Yemen border, on the Saudi side, of course, waiting to save people in humanitarian efforts. And he mentioned two particular actions that they've taken, two operations that they took place, that they took. And the basic argument is this: the Saudi Arabian government press newspaper actually states that Malaysia is involved militarily. Reuters, Bloomberg, all the international media say so, but our government knows best because this is Malaysia. If they say they are not involved, they are not involved. So that's it from Parliament this week.